वेलकम बैक. इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द नंबर रिप्रेजेंटेशन फॉर इंटीजर्स. सो इंटीजर्स आर अनसाइंड इंटीजर एंड देर इज़ अनदर पॉसिबिलिटी दैट इज साइंड इंटीजर. दैट मीन्स वी मे हैव दैट पॉजिटिव इंटीजर और वी मे हैव निगेटिव इंटीजर. सो हाउ डू वी रिप्रेजेंट द अनसाइंड एंड साइंड इंटीजर इन आर सिस्टम, दैट वी आर गोइंग टू लुक इन दिस लेक्चर. ओके, सो we know that the magnitude of any number can be expressed in n number of bits. So if n is equal to 4, we can express from 0000 to 1111, 4 zeros to 41. And what how much magnitude we can represent? So this would be 0, this would be 1, and 1111 would be 2 raised to power 4 minus 1. Okay, so if we have n bits, we can represent 0 to 2 raised to power n minus 1 unsigned, or you can say positive integers. Okay, so this would be 0 line and this would be 2 raised to power n minus 1. So we can represent this number of quantities using n bits, and this would be our positive overflow. That means if we want to represent 16 onward, okay, and since we have only 4 bits to represent, okay, we cannot represent them because our word size is 4. So this will come into the area of positive overflow. Okay, now in case of signed representation, I have already told you there are three methods. In second unit we have covered that. So first method is sign magnitude representation. Okay, so what we have in sign magnitude representation, this one bit is known as sign bit. So if this one bit is 0, that means we are going to represent a positive number. If this bit is 1, that means we are going to represent a negative number. Rest n minus 1 bits are used to represent the magnitude. Okay, so if n is equal to 4, then we can represent 0 to 7. Okay, so it would vary from 0000 to 0111. We cannot put 1 here because 1 signifies a negative number. So 0 to 7, and if we have to represent a negative number, we can represent 0001 to 1111. So this represent minus 0 and this represents minus 7. Okay, so the range here is 2 raised to power n minus 1 minus 1, that means 7. Here n is equal to 4, so if you put n is equal to 4 here, it would be 8 minus 1, that is plus 7 we can represent using sign magnitude. And what negative number we can represent, that is minus 2 raised to power n minus 1 minus 1. So 1111, this is the sign magnitude representation of minus 7. So we can represent from minus 7 to plus 7, that means the range would be minus 2 raised to power n minus 1 minus 1 to 2 raised to power n minus 1 minus 1. And if we want to represent ahead of it, it would be coming into the region of positive overflow, and this would be the region of negative underflow. Okay, so we have seen sign magnitude representation for n bit number. Now what is the problem in the previous method, that is sign magnitude representation? We have two possible equivalents for 0, that means we have 0000 for positive 0, and we have 1000 for negative 0. So we have two representations of 0, and this is why we have to use another method. So there is one more representation method, that is 1's complement. So in this 1's complement, positive numbers are represented same like as we are representing in sign magnitude form. That means 0 your sign bit and rest of the bits denotes the magnitude. But if you want to represent a negative number, what you do, this would be your sign bit, that is the first most significant bit represent the sign, and here at the magnitude part you just flip the bits. Okay, so let's say you have to represent 4, so you have to represent minus 4. In that case this would be 1. Okay, and to represent 4 you require 100, so you flip the bits. So 1011, that would be the 1's complement representation of 4 minus 4. Okay, so but here also the problem remains persist. We have two representations of 0, so that is why to avoid these problems which are present in 1's complement and sign magnitude representation, we use 2's complement representation for signed integers. Okay, so if n is equal to 4, in that case we can represent minus 2 raised to power n minus 1 to 2 raised to power n minus 1 minus 1. So this is the range for 2's complement representation. Okay, so what we do in 2's complement representation, we evaluate the 1's complement representation and then we add 1 to the 1's complement representation. Okay, so positive numbers, there is no issue, you can represent in same as sign magnitude representation. But in case of negative numbers, what you do, there is one bit sign bit, and apart from that you evaluate 2's complement, that is 1's complement plus 1. Okay, so let's say you have to represent minus 1. So once the representation of 1 is 0001, okay, then you take the 1's complement, so it would be 1110, that is 1's complement representation, and if you add 1 to it, it would be 2's complement representation of minus 1. So 1111 is the representation of minus 1. Okay, so these things we have already discussed, just a quick recap of it. Now please see the example here, represent minus 12 in 8-bit architecture. Okay, so 12 is 1100, this is 12. If you represent 12 into 8 bits, it would be 0000 1100, so this is 8 bit representation of plus 12. Now we have to represent minus 12 using 2's complement. So if we take 1's complement, so this all the bits we will flip 0 to 1, 1 to 0, so 1111 0011, and then we add 1. Okay, so in that way we can compute any negative number in n bit architecture or 8 bit architecture. Now we have seen that we can represent minus 12 in this way. Now if we add again plus 12 into this, we must get 0, because minus 12 plus 12, it would be 0. So we copy from here to here, that is minus 12 representation in 2's complement, then we add plus 12, so 0000 1100. Now you see 0000 0 plus 0 0 1 plus 1 10, so 0 here, 1 carry, 1 plus 1 0. Okay, again carry 1 1 plus 1 0, then again carry 1 1 plus 1 0 1 plus 1 0 1 plus 1 0, and this bit we discard. Okay, we truncate this bit because we are dealing here with 8 bit architecture. Okay, and if we are going to add plus 12 and minus 12 two different sign, then we cannot have overflow bit. Okay, so that is why we truncate or we ignore this bit, because we are dealing with 8 bit architecture and we are dealing with opposite signed numbers. Okay, so that is the representation of minus 12 in 8 bit architecture, and we have confirmed it that if we add plus 12, it would be coming to 0. Now there is one issue. Okay, what you are going to do actually? Okay, so if we have to compute minus 12, okay, so what would be the 2's complement representation of 12? Okay, to represent minus 12, so we are going to see that. Now what is the 1's complement of 12? Okay, so this is your plus 12 representation. Okay, now if you take 1's complement, this would be 1111 1111. If you subtract 12 from this number, you are going to get 1's complement of this number. Okay, so this is please see here, 1's complement is this, you just flip the bits, that is 1111 0011. So how you are going to get 1's complement? You subtract the positive number by all 1's. Okay, so 8 1's you subtract minus 12. So if you have to compute 2's complement representation, what you do, you add 1 to the 1's complement. So 1111 1111 plus 1, that is adding 1 to the 1's complement representation, that is 1 and 8 zeros, and if you subtract plus 12, you are going to get minus 12. Okay, so this you can also represent in 2 raised to power n minus 12. Okay, so in that way you can compute the 2's complement representation of plus 12. Okay, so it would be 2's complement representation, you can verify it. Okay, so what would be the 2's complement representation of a number? It would be 2 raised to power n minus number. I hope you have understood this thing. So what we are going to do to compute 1's complement representation, we subtract the number by all 1's. Now if you want to compute 2's complement representation, what you do, you add 1 to the 1's complement and then subtract the number. Okay, so when you add 1, it would be 1 followed by 8 0, and if you subtract 12 from it, it would be minus 12. So we will verify it in the next slide. So this is minus 12. Okay, so we take the previous expression what we have derived, that is 2 raised to power n minus number. Now 2 raised to power 8 minus 12, what would be 244. And if you are represent, if you represent 244 in binary form, it would be 1111 0100, which is the 2's complement representation of 12. Okay, which is the 2's complement representation to show that minus 12 is same as computed previously and as computed by this mathematical expression. Okay, now there is issue 2. If you have to convert 0.111 to base 10, how you can convert? You have to multiply 1 into 2 raised to power minus 1 plus 1 into 2 raised to power minus 2 plus 1 into 2 raised to power minus 3, and then you add, and then you get the result 0.875. okay, now you can also compute the same result by this trick, that is 1 minus 2 raised to power minus 3. So you are having 3 bits all ones after radix point. So if you perform 1 minus 2 raised to power minus 3, you are going to get 0.875. so these are the two tricks that I have told you, that is 2's complement representation, that is 2 raised to power n minus number, and this representation, that is 1 minus 2 raised to power minus n. These two tricks will be used in floating point representation methods and in other algorithms also. So that is why I have told you these two tricks. That is, if you want to compute the 2's complement representation, you just do 2 raised to power n minus number, and if you have all ones after radix point, you can count the number of ones, and 1 minus 2 raised to power minus n, if you do, then you will get the result. Okay, so these tricks will be used in Booth's algorithm for multiplication and in floating point representation. Okay, now with integer arithmetic, what are the possible operations we can have? We can have negation. Okay, so for negation, we already told you that for negation we will just compute 2's complement representation, or we can do 2 raised to power n minus number to negate a number, okay, or to express the number which are negative. So let's say we want to negate any number 8. If you want to compute minus 8, we just take the 2's complement representation to denote minus 8. Okay, apart from negation, there are 4 operations also, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So here we will discuss one by one, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, all operation we will discuss. So first we start with addition. So this is the representation of 3 and this is the representation of 4. If we add, we will get 7. Okay, in a similar way, addition proceeds for signed number. So this is minus 7 representation, 2's complement representation of 7, and this is 2 plus 5 0101, and if we add, we will get minus 2. So this is 2's complement representation of minus 2. So if you are if you want to verify that this is minus 2, you want, what you do, you again take the 2's complement of this 1110. So just flip the bits, so it would be 0001, add 1, so 0010. Okay, so two numbers of same sign may produce a different sign, in that situation is known to be overflow. Okay, so if you have 5 and 4, if you add, you are getting 1001. Okay, so this is overflow because you are adding two numbers of same sign, that is positive, and you are getting a number of negative sign, which says that it's a overflow condition. So if you are adding two numbers of same sign, either both positive or either both negative, and you are performing addition, and if you get one or if you get different sign, that means the situation is known to be overflow. Okay, so how to get rid of this situation? We can increase the word size, that is one possible solution. So in case of overflow, result is larger than what we can expect to store with the word. So what is the solution here is, we can increase the word size to get rid of overflow, and when overflow occurs, ALU should signal that we should not use the additive result, okay, because it contains overflow. Okay, so let's say you have to perform some very high computation, and in between those computation you have overflow. So ALU should signal that this result should not be used further because there is a overflow. Okay, now we have seen how the addition can be performed. Now the second operation is subtraction. Okay, so subtraction can be done using adding 2's complement representation to the one of the component. So let's say this is M, this is S. M is your minuend and S is your subtrahend. You have to perform M minus S. How you can subtract S from M? You can add M to minus S. So this minus S would be added to M. In that way you can perform subtraction. So let's say you have to perform 2 minus 7. So that would be equal to 2 plus minus 7. So what you do, you add 2's complement representation of this minus 7 plus 2. So 2 representation would be 0010 and 2's complement representation would be 1001. If you add, you are getting 1011, that is 2's complement representation of minus 5. Okay. So that is how you can perform subtraction. Okay. Now these both operations, how you implement these addition and subtraction in hardware. So I have made a very simple hardware circuitry. You can see that. So let's say you have to perform add A comma B. Okay. So what you do? This is A register and this is B register. Now if you want to perform addition, what you do? This A register will content will go to adder, this B register content will go to adder, and finally we perform add and store it to one of the register. Okay. Now if we want to perform the subtraction, that is A minus B, what we can do is this B register content would go first to the complementer. So it would be negated. The 2's complement representation would be evaluated in complementer. Okay. This is a switch which enables either this line or this line. So switch is used to enable this line and then it goes to adder. Okay. So in that way A minus B can be performed. Okay. And is stored back to A register. This OF represents the overflow bit. If we are having addition or subtraction operation and there is a overflow, this OF bit would be set to 1, and if we do not have a overflow, then it is set to 0. Now the third operation, that is multiplication. So how we perform multiplication using integer arithmetic. Now since it is a complex operation, we will consider here two cases. Case one would be when we perform the multiplication of two unsigned numbers, and case two would be when we perform either signed to unsigned or unsigned to signed or signed signed multiplication. Okay. So first we are going to look at unsigned multiplication. So let's say we have one number, that is 11. 11 is represented as 1011, and the another number we have, that is 13, that is 1101. Here this 1011 is called as multiplicand. Okay. And this 1101, the other quantity which we have to multiply, is known as multiplier. Okay. So please remember these terms, that is multiplicand and multiplier. Now we know this method is also called pen and pencil method, because this is the conventional way to multiply two integers, and this is the method we have been taught many years before. Okay. So 1 would be multiplied to 1011, it would be 1 multiplied to 1011, so 1011. Okay. All the same magnitude we will be getting if we multiply with 1. Okay. And if you multiply with 0, this would all become 0. Okay. So 0, when we multiply with 0, all would become 0. So 0000. Then we again shift 2 bits, we again multiply with 1, so again same magnitude, that is 1011. Then again we multiply with 1 to the 1001, shift 1 place and same magnitude, and then we add. Okay. So this 1, this 1 plus 0 1, this 0 plus 0 plus 1 would be 1, this 1 plus 1 10 and 10 plus 1 11, so 1 here, carry 1, 1 plus 1 0, carry 1, 1 plus 1 0, okay, carry 1, and 1 plus 1 is 10. So that is how we can compute the multiplication result. Okay. So this is the conventional way of doing it. If you convert this into decimal, it would be 143. You can verify that. Now please look here and see what we are doing here. Okay. We are multiplying with each of the bit to the multiplicand and we are storing the result. Okay. So we have multiplied with 1, 1011 came, then we have shifted 1 bit, again we multiplied with 0, put it here, and again we shifted 1 bit to the left. So what we are doing is we are multiplying and then shifting and then adding. Okay. So here the concept is we are evaluating partial products, shifting 1 bit to the left, and then we are adding the partial products. Okay. So what we are doing, we are evaluating partial product, we are shifting 1 bit left, and then we are performing the addition operation. So how we can map this procedure into hardware, that we are going to do. Okay, so this is how a human performs multiplication. How this method would be mapped to hardware, that we will be looking at. So hardware implementation is this. Okay, this is your multiplicand and this is your multiplier. Okay, apart from that, we will take two more resistors, that is A and C. C to store carry and A to store sum, that is sum of the partial products. Okay, so here we will have n bit adder. Okay, so what we do, we multiply it first time and then we shift and add control logic to add and shift. Again it will go to n bit adder. If there is a carry, we will take into it. Okay, this carry would again be added to A. Okay, again it would be multiplied, again shift and add control logic will give it to n bit adder. So that is how the multiplication is taking place. Okay, we will look at this diagram after we see an example now. So this is an example. Let's say we have to multiply again 13 into 11. Okay, so multiplicand is 1101, that is 8 plus 4 plus 1, that is 13, and multiplier is 1011, that is 1 plus 2 plus 8, okay, that means 11. So this is 13 and this is 11. Okay, so there are four things we initialize with. So M we know, that is multiplicand, it is 11. Q we already know, that is multiplier, that is 13. Now there are two more resistor we take, A and C, and both are initialized to 0. Okay, so A is a temporary resistor to store the addition result and C is the carry. Okay, so we will see step by step. Now we have to multiply 1011 to 1101. Okay, please see the three steps. These three steps are, we initialize A comma C to 0. We have initialized A comma C to 0. M is multiplicand, that is 11. Q is multiplier, that is 13. Now we see if Q0 is 1, then we do A is equal to A plus 1. And then we shift right. Okay. And if Q0 is equal to 0, then we only shift, perform shift operation. We do not add. Okay. Because in the previous pen and pencil method, we have seen that with 0, if we multiply all bits 0, and there is no effect on addition. Okay. Just if we need shift operation, it would solve our purpose. Now we have to perform n cycles. Okay, so this n cycles would be the total number of bits in which we are representing the number. Here 11 and 13 requires 4 bits, so we will go for 4 cycles, and after that we are done with 4 cycles, the result would be stored in AQ. So please read these steps, that if Q0 is equal to 1, A is equal to A plus 1 and shift right. If Q0 is equal to 0, no addition, only shift, and we will have to continue for n number of cycles, and after n number of cycles result would be stored in AQ. So these are very simple steps. I have written in a very simple language so that you don't have to remember it so much. Okay, so this is your 11, this is your 13, and we have initialized C and A with 0. Now how the multiplication operation will proceed? First we will add, we will see whether what is the Q0. So this is Q0, this is Q1, this is Q2, this is Q3. So first we will see what is the value of Q0. Q0 is equal to 1, that means we have to perform A is equal to A plus M. So A would be added with M. So 0000 would be added with 1011, that would be 1011. So we write 1011 here. Okay, then we have performed the addition operation. Now we would perform the shift operation. So this, there is no carry here. So 0 would, the shift operation is A, C and Q. Shift A, C, Q by 1 bit right. So C would come here, 1 would come here, 0 would come here, 1 would come here, and in similar way 1 would come here, 1 would come here, 1 would come here, 0 would come here, and this bit would be vanished because we are dealing here with only 4 bits. So this bit would be truncated, or this bit would be discarded. Now again we see what is the value of Q0. So here the value of Q0 is 0. That means we don't have to perform the addition operation, just we need to perform the shift operation. So this 0 would come here, this 010 would come here. Okay, now this 1 will come here. This 111 would be shifted to one place right here, 111, and this bit would be truncated or discarded. Now we see that what is the value of Q naught? It is 1. We have to perform addition and shift. So A is equal to A plus M. The value of A is 0010 and M is 1011. So 0010 and 1011, we perform addition. 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 10, so 0, carry 1, 1, 0 plus 1 is 1. So 1101 would be A is equal to A plus N. We write 1101 here, and rest of the things would be same. So one, all 1s and 1011. Then we perform the shift operation. So 0 would coming here, this 110 is coming here, this 1 is coming here, these all 3 1s are coming here, and this bit would be truncated. Now we again see what is the value of Q naught. It is 1. That means we again have to perform addition and shift. Okay. So A would be added to AM. So this 0110 would be added to 1011. So 0110 would be added to 1011. It would be 10001. Carry is 1 here. Okay. So carry we write 1. Okay. And this, the sum is A is equal to A plus M is 0001, carry is 1, we have written here. Then Q and M will be same. Again we perform the right shift. So this 1 will come here, these 30 will come here, this 1 will come here, these 3 ones will come here, and this bit would be truncated. So now we have carried away this process for 4 times. Okay. So this is our initialization. This is our first cycle, this is our second cycle, this is again our second third cycle, this is our fourth cycle. We have performed the that means we have gone through 4 times, cycle has run 4 times. So we will stop here, and the multiplication result is stored in AQ. So 1000 1111 is our multiplication result. What is our result? That is 1000 1111. So if you compute its decimal equivalent, it would be coming 143. Okay, so result would be stored in AQ. I hope you have understood this algorithm. Okay, now see the previous diagram. Okay, if you see the previous diagram, it would be more clear to you. Okay, so when we initialize whatever we have in multiplicand, that is added to A. Okay, and then we check what is the value of Q naught. If Q naught is 1 or 0, based upon that, this shift and add control logic will perform. So if it is 1, it would add and shift. If it is 0, it will just shift. And what is it is shifting? It is shifting all C, A, Q by 1 bit right. Okay. So it is shifting C, A, Q 1 bit right. And again, we will go to adder. We will perform A is equal to A plus M. And again, this procedure is repeating for 4 number of cycles or for n number of cycles. Okay, so that is how it is implemented in hardware. Now we see the another case. So another case is if we have to perform the signed multiplication. So for signed multiplication, we use Booth algorithm. Okay, so this is very important thing. Please look here very carefully. So when we have seen the case where we have to perform the multiplication and we have only unsigned integers, now we are going to look at signed multiplication, and that can be performed using Booth algorithm because that is very efficient to do that. Okay, so we will take an example, that is -7 into +3, it should come -21. So this would be our multiplicand, this would be our multiplier, and this is our product. Okay, so this is the algorithm which I have written. Okay, and this is the tracing table, the same as in the previous case. Okay, so what is -7? That is 2's complement notation of +7. So it is 1001, we already know that. So -7 means we will first take 0111, that is the representation of 7. Then we flip the bits, so 1000 would be 1's complement, add 1, so 1001 is the 2's complement representation of 7. Okay, so we will have -7 equivalent is 1001. Now we will also compute -m. So we again take the 2's complement representation of 1001. It is coming 0111. Okay. So this, why we have computed this -1? Because it is required in the algorithm. So we have to perform minus 7 into plus 3, and this is the algorithm. So this is oval shaped box which says that this is the start of algorithm, and then this is the procedure box which will tell us that we have to initialize this. Okay, so we have to initialize m, we have multiplicand, q we have multiplier, q naught we initialize with 0. Okay, so please remember that q naught we initialize with 0, a we initialize with 0, and n is the number of bits. Okay, so n is 4 here because 7 is represented in 1001 and 3 is represented in 0001. Okay, so this is initialization. So n is equal to 4 because we have 4 number of bits that would be given to you, don't worry. So n is equal to 4, a is equal to all zeros, we have initialized with all zeros. Okay, q is our multiplier. Okay, so q is 3, that is 0011. Q naught we initialize with 0, okay, and m is our multiplicand. So m is here 1001. Okay, now we check whether q naught q1 is 10. So if q naught q1 is 10, it would be a is equal to a minus m. If q naught q1 is 01, a is equal to a plus m. And in all other two cases, that is if q naught q1 is 0011, we do not perform addition or subtraction operation, just we shift one bit right. And then n is equal to n minus 1. Then we check if n is equal to 0. If it is not, then we again have to perform this cycle. And if n is equal to 0, result is stored in AQ. Okay. So we will apply all the steps over it. So n is equal to 4, a is equal to 0, q is equal to 3, that is 0011, q naught is equal to 0. So this is our initialization. Now we check q naught q1. So q naught is 0, q1 is 1. Okay, so it is 10, that means we have to go into this direction. Q naught q1 is 10, that means we have to perform a is equal to a minus m. How we can perform a is equal to a minus 1? So a is equal to a minus 1, that means a is equal to a plus minus m. Okay, so this a is equal to 0000, m is equal to minus m is equal to 0111. So if we perform all zeros plus 0111, so a is equal to a minus m, we have evaluated 0111, q is same, q naught is 0, we have performed a is equal to a minus m, and after that we will perform arithmetic right shift. Okay, so because here it is a is equal to a minus m, after that we will perform arithmetic right shift. So we will perform arithmetic right shift. So this 0 would be retained here. Okay, so arithmetic right shift means we retain the most significant bit and we shift including that bit. Okay, so 0 would be retained here. Okay, 0 is shifted to one bit right, and all these two ones would be here, this one would come here, and this 001 will come here, 001, and this one will come here. Okay, so in previous case it was truncated, in this case this one is coming here. So we have performed arithmetic shift right operation for a, q, q naught. Okay, so a is shifted one bit right, MSB is retained 011, then 1001 will come here, 1001 will come here, this one will come here. So we have performed arithmetic shift right. Now n is equal to n minus 1, so n is 4, n minus 1 we have done, that is 3. Now we check, will is n is equal to 0 now? No, it is not 0, so we have again back to here. Then we see again what is the value of q naught q1. So q naught is 1 and q1 is 1, so it is 11. That means it will go into this direction, that is 11. We don't have to perform any addition or subtraction, just arithmetic right shift of a, q, q naught. So a, q, q naught would be shifted one bit right, same procedure, 0 would be MSB, so it is coming here. At these three places 001 will come here. Now this 1 will come here, 1100 will come here, this 1 will come here. Okay, so we have performed arithmetic shift right. Now we again check q naught and q1. So q naught is 1, q1 is 0, so it is 10. That means we have to perform a is equal to a plus m. Okay, so a is equal to a plus m is performed, which is this 0001 would be added to 1001. Okay, so that is coming 1010. okay. Now we have performed here a is equal to a plus m. Why? Because that this q naught is 1 and q1 is 0. So we have to go in this direction, that is 0, 1. A is equal to a plus m is performed. So a is 0, 0, 0, 1 and m is 1, 0, 0, 1. So a is equal to a plus m we have performed. Okay. Then we will perform arithmetic right shift of aq q naught. So arithmetic right shift of aq q naught, 1 will come here. This 1, 0, 1 will come here. This bit will go here. This 1, 1, 0 will go here. And this bit will go here. Now we will check q naught, q1. So q naught is 0, q1 is 0. 0, 0 is there. That means 0, 0 is there. So we will have to perform only arithmetic right shift, no addition, subtraction. So arithmetic right shift of here. So 1 would be retained here. This is 1, 0, 1 here. Okay. Then this 0 will come here. This 1, 1, 0 will come here. And this 0 is coming here. Okay. So again we get 0, 0. N is equal to n minus 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1. Okay. So is n is equal to 0? No. Again we will coming here. So here again 0, 0 is there. So we will perform arithmetic right shift one more time. So this 1 will come here. 1, 1, 0 is coming here. This 1 will come here. This 0, 1, 1 will come here. And then we check, is n is equal to 0? Yes, n is equal to 0. That means we have got the result which is stored in AQ. So 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. This is our result. Okay. And this is the multiplication result, final multiplication result. Now, if we have to verify that whether we have got the correct result, we will convert it into 2's complement representation, because the most significant is bit is 1. MSB is 1, that means it is a negative number. Okay. So we will take the 2's complement, which is coming 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, plus 1. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So if we convert it to decimal, it would be minus 21. Hence, it is verified that the procedure is, whatever procedure we have gone through, that is correct. Okay. So please see the algorithm once more. We initialize m with multiplicand, q with multiplier, q naught with 0, a with 0, and n is the number of bits here. Then we check whether q naught, q1 is 1, 0, 0, 1 or 0, 0 is 1, 1. Based upon that, we will perform addition, subtraction or arithmetic right shift of aq q naught. We reduce n by 1, n is equal to n minus 1, and then we check whether n is equal to 0 or not. If not, we will again go back to here. If yes, the result is stored in aq, and here we stop. Okay. So this is your Booth algorithm for signed number multiplication. And how we represent or how we map this into hardware. So this is the hardware structure for Booth's algorithm. This is A, this is Q, this is Q naught. Okay. And that this is M, your multiplicand. And if we have 0, 1 or 0, 1, 0, based upon that, we will perform addition or subtraction. So this M would be added to A, or it is subtracted from A. If we have 1, 0 or 0, 1, so this M and A is connected to a small adder. And then we again check what is the value of Q naught. Okay. So based upon the value of Q naught, Q1, okay, based upon the value of Q naught, Q1, this A and M will be added or subtracted. And here from here, it will again go back to A. So this is the simple hardware structure for Booth's algorithm. Now we will see how the last operation, that is division. Okay. So for division operation, we will look into it in the next lecture. Okay. So thank you for today's lecture. And in this lecture, we have covered addition, subtraction, multiplication operation for integer representation.